watching News Epicenter with me, Maria Shakil. The power plays continue in battleground Uttar Pradesh, and now the eyes are turning to Western UP, the Jat Kisan heartland, where the BJP has a tough task to ensure that post the farmer agitation, that crucial constituency remains with them. Today, the Bharatiya Kisan Union's Naresh Tikait met BJP MP from Muzaffarnagar and Union Minister Sanjeev Balyan. Sources tell CNN News 18 that the Tikait clan won't be openly endorsing any party, but they are leaning towards a Samajwadi party-led coalition. The Tikaits have a huge reach in Western UP. They come from the politically dominant Balyan Khap, with Jat and Muslim farmers extending. In fact, they have that influence in over 60 assembly seats. BJP had bagged 50 of these seats in the 2017 elections, while the Jat factions backed the BJP in the 2017, 2014 Lok Sabha, 2019 Lok Sabha as well. In fact, the BJP bucked that perception that it was losing the support of Jat farmers since 2017 over a host of issues, including the sugarcane pricing. In 2014, after ensuring they get support of 77% of this crucial constituency, the BJP secured 91% of the Jat votes in 2019. In a bid to upset that balance, the Samajwadi Party has allied with the RLD, and Akhilesh Yadav launched the Anna Sankalp with a resolution to defeat the Yogi government and ensure justice for farmers. UP Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath lashed out at the Samajwadi Party, questioning how people who supported terrorists and criminal elements were suddenly speaking for farmers and taking resolutions in their name. The focus is also on the critical Muslim vote bank, where the myth of Muslims voting en masse has been busted in multiple elections. In past elections, the Samajwadi Party has held the biggest chunk of Muslim votes. In 2014, the SP and BSP secured 58% and 18% of the vote bank. And on a united front in 2019, when SP-BSP came together, it was a Mahagathbandhan, they secured 73% of the Muslim vote. But that did not really ensure that they would win those seats in the crucial Western UP belt. Muslim leaders do not have a singular home in any one political party. This is emerging from the SP camp as days after joining hands with the party, former Congress leader and Saharanpur heavyweight Imran Masood is unhappy with Akhilesh Yadav. According to sources, after not getting ticket, Imran Masood and his aide, Masood Akhtar, have claimed that Akhilesh Yadav humiliated them and denied them a place on stage when several BJP leaders from the OBC, in fact, joined the party recently. That image on your television screens. Reports suggest he may find a place in Mayawati's camp now, but he's denying that. So these are the latest political dynamics from the poll-bound state, where the Samajwadi Party hopes to make major gains in Western UP, while the BJP hopes to maintain its hold on the politically powerful Jat farmers, scrambling to undo the political fallout of the farmer agitation. So where will Western UP turn, as we are just days ahead of the crucial election that begins in Western UP? Before we get to our guests, listen in to this exclusive conversation I had with Naresh Tikait of the BKU on his meeting with BJP leader Sanjeev Balyan. Naresh ji, हमसे बात करने के लिए बहुत-बहुत शुक्रिया. कुछ देर पहले आपकी और संजीव बालियान जी, जो केंद्रीय मंत्री हैं और मुजफ्फरनगर के सांसद हैं भाजपा के, उनसे आपकी मुलाकात हुई. तस्वीर पब्लिक डोमेन में भी आ गई है. क्या बातचीत हुई है?
तो संजीव बालियान भी यही परिवार के ही है, हमारे सांसद भी है. तो आगे हमारा भी चोट लग रही है, इसका पता लेना आगे. तो इसमें तो कोई वो नहीं है, बातचीत क्या हुआ है. आ सके, कोई भी आ सके.
जी बिल्कुल, कोई भी आ सकता है, सही बोला आपने। लेकिन चुनाव के इस माहौल में जब कोई बातचीत होती है, जबकि आप और भारतीय किसान यूनियन खुल करके भाजपा का विरोध कर रही है, उस माहौल में अगर ये मुलाकात होती है तो ये जरूर पॉलिटिकल होगी। क्या ये माना जाए कि अब टिकैत परिवार भाजपा को सपोर्ट करेगा?
नहीं, सपोर्ट तो किसी भी पार्टी को नहीं। ये तो जो कोई आ रहे आशीर्वाद ले रहे यहाँ से, बस ठीक है, ऐतिहासिक जगह किसान भवन, यू टिकैत परिवार, टिकैत का घर, यहाँ से तो आ जाए आदमी, इसमें तो कोई वो नहीं, उस तरह ना जोड़ कर चले।
आप आशीर्वाद की बात कर रहे हैं, सब आकर टिकैत परिवार से आशीर्वाद लेते हैं, क्योंकि जरूर आपका किसानों के बीच में काफी ज्यादा दबदबा है। मेरा सवाल अब आपसे ये होगा कि क्या, किस डायरेक्शन में, क्या सोच रहा है किसान वेस्टर्न यूपी का, किसको समर्थन देना चाहिए?
नहीं, वो तो जनता ही चुनेगी, जनता की है राइट। हम तो एक किसान संयुक्त मोर्चे का हमारे पे भी प्रतिबंध है, कोई जो कोई निर्णय लिया जाएगा संयुक्त मोर्चे से लिया जाएगा, हम अकेले को कोई राइट नहीं है इस बात का।
लेकिन अरे जी, सवाल ये उठेगा कि जो आपके भाई हैं राकेश टिकैत, वो तो खुल करके भाजपा का विरोध कर रहे हैं और खुल करके आरएलडी और सपा का समर्थन कर रहे हैं, तो क्या परिवार में भी कुछ अनबनी है, कोई डिफरेंट डायरेक्शन में आप लोग सोच रहे हैं भाई भाई?
वो तो अपने नजरिया है, जो कुछ भी बात है तो कहीं ना कहीं तो जब 13 महीने 13 महीने वहाँ बोर्ड रूप में बैठे रहे तो कहीं ना कहीं विरोध तो हो ही है। जो फिलहाल जो सत्ता में पार्टी है तो उसका तो विरोध तो लाजमी है, पर देखो तो जो कुछ भी है तो संयुक्त मोर्चे को एक वहाँ इलाहाबाद में मीटिंग चल रही जो शिविर है 3 दिन का, उसमें क्या निर्णय लिया जा, अभी तो हम कुछ नहीं कह सकते इस बारे में।
आप हर बार की तरह इस बार भी आप वो सस्पेंस बनाए रखना चाहते हैं कि किस तरफ किसान और जाट किसान फाइनली जाएगा। लेकिन किसानों को क्या संदेश देना चाहेंगे, क्योंकि चुनाव सर पर है और जो पहला चुनाव है, जो 7 फेज में पहला चुनाव जो होगा, पहले चरण का चुनाव, वो वेस्टर्न यूपी में होगा।
वे किसान तो खुद जान सके कौन सरकार थारे माफिक है, कौन खिलाफ है, वे तो वही अपना निर्णय लेंगे। कि हम किसी को बाध्य नहीं करते, हम तो पहले भी राजनीति की संगठन रहा है और इब भी राजनीति की है, हम उसी में ठीक रहे बातचीत, हम ज़्यादा नहीं वो करते किसी उसमें।
ऑल राइट नरेश टिकैत, अप्रिशिएट योर टाइम, थैंक यू हमसे बातचीत करने के लिए। लेट मी ब्रिंग इन माय गेस्ट्स नाउ, जफर इस्लाम, मेंबर ऑफ पार्लियामेंट ऑफ द बीजेपी, Vivek Silas, he is the spokesperson of the Samajwadi Party, Radhika Ramasation, columnist. Inderjeet Singh is a leader of the RLD. Radhika, has that sentiment or the anger that we saw perhaps among the farmers from the Jat community, has that fizzled out with the farmer agitation now over?
Number of things have happened. Of course, contentious, disputatious laws have been revoked. And very interestingly, Rakesh Tikait made a statement yesterday, which his brother has kind of recanted today. He restated that in that interview with you, that we are not going to support any party, whoever comes can take our blessings. Now, this to me looks like, is he reflecting the sentiments of his community on the ground? Because I still don't, I am not convinced about the Jat vote shifting en masse away from the BJP. They've always been voting the BJP since 1989, in large numbers, in middling numbers, whatever.
Yes.
It's been one consistent vote bank of the BJP. And Western UP has kind of been a BJP guard for quite long. So I'm not sure which way the Jat vote is going. I mean, it's quite possible that a big section may go with the RLD, and one section may remain with the BJP. But the fact that the Tikait clan itself is talking in different voices shows that they are conflicted about And moving away
Radhika, from
the
what we
BJP.
heard, that they were openly against the BJP, to now, you know, Naresh Tikait telling me that let there be discussion, and the discussion will be held during the 3-day sammelan that will be held, and now clearly saying that they are not backing any particular political party. There is a clear shift here. Inderjeet ji, is the RLD worried? Because as far as the Tikaits are concerned, who you got support of in the past, they have changed their tune.
देखिए मैडम जी, बात यह है कि जब 14 महीने तक निरंतर ये आंदोलन शांतिपूर्ण तरीके से जारी रहा, उस टाइम उनके सुख दुख के साथी कौन रहे? आपको याद होगा चौधरी अजीत सिंह जी ने टिकैत जी को फोन करके ये कहा था कि आप अकेले नहीं हैं, आप अपने अपनी लड़ाई अकेले के लिए नहीं लड़ रहे हैं, आप पूरे भारत के किसानों की लड़ाई लड़ रहे हैं। जिस तरीके से उनको वहां से जबरदस्ती उठाने के लिए एक मोमेंटम बनाया गया था, एक माहौल बनाया गया था, चौधरी अजीत सिंह जी आपने राकेश टिकैत जी को फोन करके हिम्मत दी थी कि पूरे उत्तर प्रदेश नहीं पूरे देश का किसान आपके साथ है, आपकी अपनी पर्सनल लड़ाई नहीं है, और वो हिम्मत बढ़ी।
वो जब लड़ाई चल रही थी तब की बात है, लड़ाई खत्म हो चुकी है, कानून वापस ले लिया है भाजपा ने, अब तो सवाल चुनाव पर है। और हमने ये देखा है, जैसा राधिका ने कहा, 1989 से जाट हमेशा भाजपा के साथ रहा है। 2019 के चुनाव से पहले भी एक नैरेटिव बना कि शायद किसान और जाट नाराज है भाजपा से, वो नहीं दिखा। बल्कि अगर हमारे पास जो स्टेटिस्टिक्स है वो आप देखिएगा, वो साफ तौर पे ये बताता है कि जो जाट 77% भाजपा के साथ खड़े थे 2014 के चुनाव में, दैट वेंट अप टू 91% इन 2019। If anything, they have been standing and standing firmly with the BJP. Then what is giving you hope when the tune of the tickets have changed?
देखिए मैडम जी, बात क्या है, आदमी हमारे यहाँ पंजाबी में कहावत है, राह पे आ जानी है या वहां पे आ जानी है, मीन्स रास्ते पे जाएंगे तो पता लगेगा रास्ता कैसा है, वहां पे आ जानी है मीन्स वास्ता पड़ेगा तो पता लगेगा। किसान भाइयों ने, जाट भाइयों ने ट्रस्ट दिखाया, उन्होंने अपने घर को छोड़ा, चौधरी चरण सिंह जी का परिवार, चौधरी अजीत सिंह जी का परिवार, जैन चौधरी का परिवार एक जाट समाज का एक बड़ा परिवार है, जिन्होंने हमेशा उनको शेल्टर दिया, उनके सुख दुख में ये परिवार खड़ा रहा।
The fact that the RLD stood with the farmers during the agitation is giving them hope that the Kisan farmers and the Jats will be standing with them in the elections. When the agitation was supposed to be apolitical, they get political backing, and then ahead of the elections, this is the statement.
Is the question
to you? Yes.
Is this question
Zafar Islam?
To,
yes.
For me,
yes.
Yeah. Maria, they are trying to take undue advantage of the situation, but the situation initially what they thought will work in their favor is no longer working in their favor. It was never in their favor. Perception wise they were thinking, but situation and dynamics have changed completely. They have always supported Bharatiya Janata Party, they will continue to support Bharatiya Janata Party, and we know for sure the feedback that we have from the ground that we are not going to lose ground to any other political parties. As Radhika ji rightly pointed out, that there is unlikely that Jat vote will move out of BJP camp. They are intact, and you will see the numbers which has grown from 77% to 91% in 2019, from 2017. It will remain somewhere close to 90% this time as well. No matter what they try to preach or mislead the Jat community, but Jat community knows that the only political party which has always worked for their welfare is Bharatiya Janata Party, and they will continue to work for their upliftment and welfare. And we have won their confidence since 1989, as you rightly pointed out. We continue to have their confidence, we continue to have their trust,
okay,
and we will deliver to their expectation. And
okay,
no longer
now,
that.
Now, let me
that
talk
the,
about another
the,
crucial
the
constituency of Western UP,
the,
that is the Muslims. And on that, I'll bring the Samajwadi Party spokesperson Vivek Silas. Vivek ji, question is, what went wrong between Imran Masood and the Samajwadi Party? Why is he so upset with you? You have to unmute. Yes. Yes, go ahead.
Today we talk about farmers. Very good evening to all of you. And we talk about the farmers of Western UP. The basis of Bharatiya Janata Party and the promises, the basis is that the government was supposed to double the income of farmers by 2022, and we have already landed in 2022, and we can see what actually the ground situation is. Today, the farmers have expensive electricity, expensive diesel, and, you know, shortage of DAP and urea. In Western UP, the ship of the Bharatiya Janata Party, ma'am, has already sunk. The farmers are waiting for the day, this day to come. The Samajwadi Party and the RLD are a formidable force in Western UP at the moment.
What went wrong between Imran Masood and Akhilesh Yadav?
Imran Masood was a leader who came from the Congress to the Samajwadi Party.
Yes.
And I will not be able to clear very much on that. But something must have gone wrong. That's why he has some resentment against us. I don't know what is the matter is. I cannot comment much on that.
Yes. But Imran Masood is supposed to be a political heavyweight as far as Saharanpur and that belt is concerned. He has been denied ticket. And that entire Muzaffar Nagar belt, the Samajwadi Party and the RLD have been very careful in not fielding a single Muslim candidate. What is giving you that confidence that you may not be giving Muslims a political representation in terms of fielding them or giving them ticket, and still that constituency will be standing with you?
Actually, ma'am, the thing is that the confidence comes from your leader. The confidence comes from the reports that we get from the ground. The people are supporting the Samajwadi Party, definitely this time in 2022. The resentment of people, the displeasure of people, the irritation and dissatisfaction that has come up is, now change that. On ground level, it's something else. The way the Bharatiya Janata Party has cheated the people, they have avoided the people, they have offended the people, and they have misused the people, I would say that. So it's not only about the farmers or the minorities. If I say today the OBCs, the Dalits, the minorities, the Brahmins, the upper class, the businessmen, women, everyone has been a victim of the Bharatiya Janata Party for the last 5 years. So the resentment that is in the heart of people of Uttar Pradesh will come out definitely.
Okay, Zafar Islam, a quick response from you, and then I'll take this discussion forward with Radhika.
They are assuming, they are daydreaming, that they will have support of Chart community, or for that matter, the society at large. We, you have shown all the numbers, statistics on your screen. I think the Samajwadi spokesperson must see those numbers before even speaking about it. I don't know whether the
history
community
now
will only vote for them. You have shown that 10%. Muslim community had voted for BJP, 11% for Congress, 18% for BSP, and 58%. But this time, I'm sure that slightly the dynamics has changed. But we will continue to attract 10 to 15% of Muslim community's vote.
But you know,
maybe 20% is what
Indra
we are G, assuming.
While we look at various constituencies and we can discuss which way, a particular community will vote or could vote, but we have seen how election after election, the BJP has almost made the minority vote redundant with their consolidation of the majority. And that has happened in the entire Western UP belt.
देखिए मनोज जी, मैं तो पहले तो जफर लाल साहब जो कह रहे हैं कि हमारे साथ जाट वोट बैंक इस सन में भी था, इस सन में भी था. जाट वोट बैंक ने अपने घर को छोड़ के आप पे ट्रस्ट करा. 700 किसानों ने अपनी जान दे दी. मैं आपसे एक रिक्वेस्ट करना चाहता हूं, जफर अलाम साहब के पास को उनके मोबाइल पे आपके टीवी चैनल के पास कोई ऐसा फोटो नजर आ जाए कि बीजेपी का लीडर किसी भी 700 किसान में से 7 आदमियों के घर नहीं, एक मिनट के लिए भी अगर किसी घर में किसान में जाके उसने अपने गिल्टी फील करा हो, उसको जाके उसकी साथ अपनी भावनाएं बांटी हो, तो मैं जानता हूं कि जाट इनके साथ फौरन उसके बाद दोबारा खड़ा रहेगा. एक भी सिंगल पर्सन कार्यकर्ता से लेकर नेता तक, राष्ट्रीय नेता तक,
प्रदेश लेवल तक कोई भी आदमी किसी 700 किसान में से एक घर में नहीं गया, और उसके बाद जब लास्ट जब तक चुनाव आता है ये आपस में जिन्ना हिंदू मुस्लिम ईद दिवाली पर चले जाते हैं। मैं कह रहा हूँ पौने 5 साल जफर अलाल साहब को मिले थे, फुल मैंडेट के मिले थे, इनके पास सब कुछ करने को मिला था, क्या करा इन्होंने?
Is the BJP feeling the heat because of the किसान agitation? You did not do much in those 13 months.
Not at all.
देखिए,
नॉट एट ऑल।
मैं उनका
जवाब हिंदी में देना चाहता हूँ। वेल, लेट मी रिस्पॉन्ड टू दिस क्वेश्चन इन हिंदी। सिंस ही हैज रिस्पॉन्डेड इन हिंदी, आई वुड वांट टू रिस्पॉन्ड इन हिंदी एज वेल। देखिए, मैं इनको बताना चाहता हूँ कि अगर किसान की कोई हितैषी सरकार है शुरू से इंद्रजीत जी, वो भारतीय जनता पार्टी की सरकार रही है। आप ये बताइए कि अगर इसी उत्तर प्रदेश की बात करें तो 36,000 करोड़ का अगर किसी ने माफ किया ऋण को, तो किसने माफ किया? हमने ही तो माफ किया, हमारी सरकार ने तो माफ की, इसलिए कि हम आपकी चिंता करते हैं, किसानों की चिंता करते हैं।
और मैं उसके आप बोल दीजिए, नहीं मैं आपके बात का जवाब जरूर मिल
जी, बिल्कुल बिल्कुल दूंगा। अब आप मुझे बोल लेने दे, या पहले आप बोल दे फिर मैं बोल दूंगा, मुझे कोई दिक्कत नहीं। पिछले 2014 से अभी तक का अगर आप पूरा आंकड़ा उठा के देखिए, तो हमने हर वो कोशिश की है इनकी आमदनी बढ़ाने के लिए, इनको सम्मान निधि देने की, इनके इनपुट कॉस्ट कम करने की, इनको नीम कोटेड यूरिया देने की, इनका जो इंश्योरेंस कराने की, इनको पेंशन देने की, और साथ साथ किसान एफपीओ बनाया जिससे किसान सर्विसेज के अंतर्गत बहुत सारी सुविधाएं और देने की। इसका मकसद क्या? उसके साथ साथ जो स्वामीनाथन कमीशन की रिपोर्ट थी उसके जो रिकमेंडेशन थे उसको भी इम्प्लीमेंट करने का काम 2018-19 में किया। देखिए, हमारी कोशिश ये है कि किसान समाज को, किसान भाई बहनों का को मजबूत करना है। हो सकता है कि इनके नजरों से कुछ कम हुआ होगा, लेकिन हम कमिटेड हैं और करेंगे आगे।
I have got exactly two minutes and I have to give it to Radhika. You got your time, Radhika. While we have discussed the Jat voters and we are seeing that ambiguity emerge from they being clearly opposed to BJP, now they are open to the idea of perhaps doing business with the BJP, what about the minority vote, a crucial constituency that we used to discuss a lot before 2014 and that constituency increasingly becoming politically irrelevant in UP?
Yeah, exactly. That's one of the points, one of the trends that the BJP has been able to establish since 2014, that the minority votes really don't matter to the extent that they seemed to in the past. Now, with regard to Imran Masood, you took the specific example.
Yes.
Example. I think Akhilesh has a problem of plenty. You know, he took a lot of people in from the BJP and the Congress and whatever. But then, you know, he's also got sitting MLAs in Saranpur. And I think there's a lot of pressure on him not to forgo the seats of his sitting MLAs for defectors. I think that must have affected Imran Masood's chances. And second of all, Imran Masood is identified with a radicalized stream of politics, unfortunately. So that may not suit Akhilesh's
But then in that case, Radhika, why will you open your doors for him?
Well, I mean, you ensured that he joined. Yes,
it
exactly.
may be an attempt at neutralizing him. But I'm just saying that politically, Imran Masood becomes irrelevant now in this election.
Well, I mean, you yourself said there are rumors that he's tapping the BSP. One doesn't know for sure, but he does seem to be out on a limb, on a limb at the moment. If the SP has not accommodated him or has told him that in future we will give you something, but that's neither here nor there.
Yes. Radhika, thank you so much for joining us. Zafar Islam, Vivek Silas and Inderjeet Singh, thank you so much for joining us and sharing your thoughts. Of course, it's a story a day in battleground UP. A story which is developing very, very fast. There are developments happening in each and every camp. Today, it was about Naresh Tikait, a very important member of Bharatiya Kisan Union, opening his doors in a way, not clearly coming out in support of the opposition-led alliance, saying that they will not be giving Ashirwads to any. That's all from me. Thanks so much for watching.